Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Wang. Here is the question. We want to simplify 2022 squared plus 1, then divided by 2021 squared plus 2022 squared plus 2023 squared plus 1. In general, how to solve this kind of question? Look at the denominator. 2021, 2022, 2023, all three consecutive numbers. If we have consecutive numbers, like those three numbers, here is the general idea. We define a new variable, which is the middle one. The middle one will be 2022. If we define 2022 as X, what is 2021 in terms of X? It should be X minus 1. What is 2023? It should be X plus 1. X minus 1 squared, X plus 1 squared. If we expand both, we will find one is negative, one is positive for X. So we can cancel. You can see here. X minus 1 square, X plus 1 square here. We have X here. See? So expand this one and this one. You have X square minus 2X plus 1. Here you have X square plus 2X plus 1. So here positive 2X, negative 2X, you can cancel. You don't have an X term in the denominator. So here we have X square, X square, X square. So we have 3X square. We have constant 1 and 1 and 1 here. So add them to 3. From the denominator, you can see 3 is a factor. We can factor 3 out. Then we have 3 times X square plus 1. Numerator, that's X square plus 1. We can cancel X square plus 1 from both numerator and denominator, we have 1/3. This is a typical method used a lot in solving or simplify math questions like this. For example, I have other tips like this from YouTube. Look at here, x plus 1 to the power 4, x plus 3 to the power 4. What is a midterm or what is the average? Midterm should be X plus 2. Here, X plus 1, X plus 2, X plus 3 looks like consecutive numbers. So we define the middle one as a Y. So X plus 2 as a Y. So here, X plus 1 should be Y minus 1. X plus 3 should be Y plus 1. Use the binomial formula to expand this term and this term. You will have some negative term here, cancel the positive term here, then simplify the question. Look at this one, also another tape on my channel. So in general, how to solve this quadratic equation to find the answer for X? Expand this part product and move 5 to the left-hand side. This is a quadratic equation. Use quadratic formula to find the X. So here, you don't have to use the quadratic formula. 3 and 7, which number is in between in the middle? That's 5. So X plus 5 is the average. So we define X plus 5 as a Y, the new variable. X plus 3 should be Y minus 2. X plus 7 should be Y plus 2. Y minus 2, Y plus 2, the product should be Y squared minus 2 squared. So Y squared minus 4 equals 5. Y squared equals 1. So Y equals positive 1 or negative 1. What is Y? X plus 5. X plus 5 equals plus 1 minus 1. Then you can find x, the two values, without using the quadratic formula. That's all. Thanks for watching and see you next time.